now it is time to welcome our first speaker, the Executive Director of the Nobel Peace Center, Kjersti Fløgstad. Give her a warm hand.
Thank you so much, Ingvild. Tomorrow, it's exactly 11 months since the Nobel Committee announced that Narges Momodi was awarded the Peace Prize for 2023. It was widely applauded around the world because it recognizes the immense importance of the cause of Narges, her fight for women's rights, for human rights for all. Dear Excellencies, dear Nobel Peace Prize laureates, dear ladies and gentlemen, dear friends, welcome to this year's Nobel Peace Prize conference. I'm overwhelmed and grateful for all the speakers who have come all the way to Norway to participate with us here today, and also for the audience filling up this big hall beyond its limits, and also that we have already thousands of viewers, as we saw online. Yet, we feel a painful absence. Throughout these 11 months, Narges is still held in Evin prison in Iran. She is imprisoned for her steadfast fight for freedom, democracy, equality, and human rights, which she rightfully claims are rights that belong to everyone. Although Narges cannot be with us physically here today, her presence is still strongly felt in many ways. Here in this venue, we have since December showcased the year's Peace Prize exhibition, also titled Woman, Life, Freedom. This exhibition has brought her story to life in this very room. Her own words to illuminate these beautiful, her own words illuminated in these beautiful lanterns, stories she has bravely penned down and smuggled out of prison for us to show you. They are also been printed in a little book that is available in our museum shop if you would like to read them thoroughly. They are really, really beautiful. And here, together with us today, Narges' husband, Tagi, and her children, Jana and Ali, are wholeheartedly present. Ali and Kiana have carried their mother's voice with strength and conviction this past year. I have no doubt that Narges is immensely proud of you, just as you are of her, and I get very touched by this. Over the past 11 months, the Nobel Peace Centers have worked tirelessly to highlight Narges' prize and her cause. Through this exhibition, educational resources, and numerous of events, we have placed Narges' fight and the women's movement at the forefront of our efforts. Today's conference is the culmination of this effort for us. We have seen how deeply Narges' fight resonates with the public. Visitors are moved to tears by her struggle for basic freedom when they come and learn about what's happening in Iran and what's happening with Narges. To be free, to sing, dance, and laugh, these are rights we often take as granted and as normal, yet they remain elusive for so many. I am pleased to announce that later today, we will officially launch the Free Narges Coalition on this stage. It works to coordinate and strengthen the efforts to support Narges in her fight for freedom. You will learn more about that very soon. In our world today, I believe strongly that we need courageous role models who are willing to place justice above all else. These heroes, just like Nargis, inspire hope. Hope that change is possible and that someone is willing to go the extra mile and beyond to fight for this hope for us, and that the world can become a more peaceful place for everyone. Developments in gender rights have moved in the wrong direction in many parts of the world in recent years. Last week, we learned that Taliban has intensified its repressive measures, now even banning women's voices and faces in public Afghanistan. We will hear more about that a little later. At the Nobel Peace Conference, we have brought together some of the world's strongest activists for women's rights and gender equality to discuss how we can reverse this trend. And thank you for being here, and warmly welcome to you that we will have on the stage later. I just want to give all of our speakers a round. Before I hand over the floor to the next speaker, I would like to extend a heartfelt gratitude to our partners who have made this conference possible. A big thank you to our main partners, Hydro and Reitan Retail, as well as to the City of Oslo, the Bergesen Foundation, and the Embassy of France to the Kingdom of Norway for their support. This year's collaboration with United World College, as we saw on the stage, is also very much appreciated. With that, it is my great pleasure to hand the floor over to Andreas Motzfeldt Kravik, State Secretary in the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, who will deliver the opening speech of this conference. Give Andreas Motzfeldt Kravik a warm applause and very much welcome.